With the release of Affinity Designer 2.5, we have the exciting addition of the Stroke Width tool. This handy feature provides users with an on-document way to create strokes containing multiple weights. Previously, this was only possible by adding a pressure profile on the stroke panel or by using a custom brush. In this video, I'm going to explain how to use the Stroke Width tool and then show it in action as I create this owl illustration, so keep watching to the end to see the process. After updating to Affinity Designer 2.5, you'll find the Stroke Width tool on the toolbar. The keyboard shortcut is W. I'm going to demonstrate the Stroke Width tool on a basic 20 pixel curve. To use it, simply select the Width tool and touch your cursor at any point on the line. Drag away from the center of the line to make the line thicker, and drag towards the center of the line to make it thinner. You can add as many width points to the line as you like, just as long as there's space. For accuracy, you can manually enter a stroke thickness value by clicking and pressing the Control key on a PC or the Command key on a Mac. Make sure to hit the Enter button after adding the number. This is particularly useful if you have a number of strokes which you'd like to all be the same width. You can easily drag a width point after creating it. And as you can see, the width changes as you do this. But if you drag while holding down the Control button on a PC or the Command key if you're on a Mac, the point will move without adjusting the width. To do the opposite, modifying a point's width without moving its position, simply hold the Shift key while you drag outwards or inwards. If you want to remove a width point, simply double-click on it. Additionally, there are some other options in the context toolbar. This button locks the line weight, which means no width point can be greater than the overall stroke weight of the curve. So, for example, the curve we're working on is set to 230 points. When I press the button, I can't make any width points any wider than 230 points. But when this option is turned off, I can make the width points as wide as I like. This button locks point ordering. This means that when enabled, the point order is fixed, and no point may pass another. When I turn it off, the points can pass again. This option is Snap to Curve Nodes. When enabled, any nodes on the curve will show as small white dots, and the width points will snap to the nodes. To demonstrate, I'll first switch to the Node tool and add a node. Now, I'm switching back to the Width tool, and as you can see, the width points now snap to the new node when dragged. This button is snapped to widths on same curve. When enabled, it will snap the width point to any pre-existing width point on the same curve. One downside with the new tool is that you can't use it on dashed lines, and you can only currently add symmetrical width profiles. Hopefully these functions will get added with a future update. The good news is that you can use the stroke width tool with vector brushes, and here's how. First, draw a brush stroke using a vector brush. I'm using one of Artifex Forge's charcoal brushes. To see the full pack, follow the link in the description. To add the width profile, you must first enable size variance in the individual brush settings. To do this, double-click the relevant vector brush icon on the brushes panel. When the options open, move the size variance slider as required. The higher the number, the larger the range of sizes available. Click close. Then use the width tool on the drawn brush stroke. If you want to reset your width profile, you can easily do so on the stroke panel. Simply open the stroke panel, click on the pressure curve icon here, and press reset. Now it's time to see the stroke width tool in action. Keep watching to see me transform these basic curves and complete the owl illustration. I hope you now have a greater understanding of how the Stroke Width tool works and are ready to try it for yourself. Don't forget to check out our other videos and follow our channel for more tips and tricks. And please also check out artfxforge.com to see our vast range of affinity brushes, textures and toolkits. You can also grab some freebies. Follow the link in the description now.